Shekoyach, Jeremy, thank you. Thank you, Hashem, that Baruch Hashem, we could be here. Jeremy, you should have, if there's still in Yanima, there should be refuah shlema for the whole deal. And you and Tila should have many more years of being married, besimcha. And the humor of Ari in our lives, because it's just too crazy. It's just too intense. It's just too meshuggah. All right, brothers, we are back. We are back. I'm going to hand out these pages for those that don't have the... for the spread, for those that need the pages, please look inside. And those who have the Sfarim Daf Pei Gimel, I don't have, for some reason, the sheet of who we are learning in honor is not here. Did anyone see it? The sponsorship page? Is it there? Thanks, Ben. Okay. We continue learning. Elu Leilun Nishmas Bas Yafega Bas Yisrael Bani Silver Lea Shalom. Also, Leilu Nishmat Avram Chai Ben Yosef Shimon for the Refuah Shlema of Moshe Asher Ben Malka Le'arachel Bas Chaya. And this week is sponsored by the space in memory of Miriam Bat Elchanan Levi, Zichron Livracha, and Menachem Ben Yona, Zichron Livracha, both Neshama Shlev and Aliyah. And as we've experienced now consecutive days, may there be no more Tumchei Nazis / Hamas allowed back into Efrat this week or ever. Bezrat Hashem. So I want to just learn as a Shabbach Ve'odah to Hashem for the miracle. We have no idea what happened yesterday. We don't have any idea what's Bichlal going on, but we have no idea. We have no idea what took place. We have no idea what happened in Lebanon. We have no concept. We have no Hasagam Bichlal. We don't understand these things at all. We don't understand the good. We don't understand the bad. Whatever it should be, we should have emunah shlema that everything right now is biyad Hashem, and Hashem is orchestrating everything so that the malchus of Hashem will be recognized by all this Rosh Hashanah. By melocha kol ha'olam kula b'chvadecha. That's all we want. That's all we want, Ribbono Shel Olam.
Also, Leila Mishmat, the soldiers that were killed yesterday, once Melazar.
Nachon, Dotan. Hashem yikom damam. Bekarov mamash. Hashem, like Idan Amedi said that time in the tank. Hashem ve'anachnu nikom damam bezrat Hashem. So, chaver, we learned last week Avodah Ivrit. That was the shir from Rav Ginsburg, was all about Avodah Ivrit, which is just beyond how everything is so connected to what we're investing, what we're putting so much strength in over here. You know, imagine living in Chutz La'aretz and learning about Avodah Ivrit. It could be the greatest learning in the world, but le'asemota, to make it a real thing in Eretz Yisrael, takes the learning to a completely different place of Lamaisa.
The Tanya said from Elazar is not a strong connections to the entire craft.
Yeah, the mother works in is the worker of the Moatsa.
Harith is the girl to the person, she makes everything happen in the Mechleket Hadassa in Efrat. Nothing.
For years.
Including the entire building we're sitting in, every single one of the houses that we are living in, were built bizkuta, and her ability to make and get things moving, Machleket Hadassa, unfortunately it was her son, and
she had already lost a daughter.
She also lost a daughter 10 years ago as well. Wow. So it's really
Shem Rishma.
Heavy talk today, especially for a crowd that for Ozark.
We need big Yeshuas, like yesterday, more and more and more and more. B'shabi b'nafochul, that it shouldn't be that when good things happen, then we have to cry. Good things happen, and then good things should happen, and then good things should happen. Okay, thank you for mentioning that. What we're going to be seeing today is a very important piece that has to do with real Gvura, that comes from love. A very interesting thing happened this last year on Reb Shlomo's Yortzeit, the 29th Yortzeit. I had come across some very powerful pieces of audio where he's screaming. Where he's screaming about Eretz Yisrael in ways you don't usually hear him scream. Like mamish letting it out. There was only two things he screamed about, you know that? Two things. One is like mamish, we have recordings of him screaming about this. One is Eretz Yisrael. Not just in 93, but whenever it came to things where you're messing with Eretz Yisrael, and Jews for Jesus, he also lost it on those things. Those two things, Jews for Jesus and Eretz Yisrael. I sent the audio to a bunch of very prominent artists, different ones, mamash, and they all had the same exact responses. Ken, anachnu baemet tzrichim la לעבוד על הנקודה הזאת של השמאל, של הנקודה השמאלית שלנו. Not the left wing, politically, I'm saying, what left represents. We also have to work on the Gvura side of us and not just talk and sing about love and love and love. Rather, we have to also speak about the inyan of the Gvura that needs to emerge from the left side. Now, what's amazing is that what we're going to see today by Rav Ginsburg, remember, this is a Kabbalistic approach to fixing the Medina. He's going to show us how Smol and Yamin, we mamish need, forget about what the world has done with left and right. But the attributes of left and right, when it comes to practically speaking, as practical as possible, in Kabbalah, we need to see how left can only truly emerge from right. And in order to understand what that even means, we have to learn inside a few basic concepts, but we're going to see, we're going to meet a figure today that we always know, we get very excited when we think about him, but he's much bigger than the credit that he gets. So look at the bottom of Pei Gimel. B'shlav haba. Le'achar hafnamat midat ha-chesed. After chesed has been internalized. B'perek haba, b'itorerut, nifne la'asok b'perek haba, b'itorerut midat ha-gvura. Now gvura has to be accelerated. הנצרכת לנו, which we need, על מנת לחסל את הטרור. In order to completely destroy terrorism, you can't just be in love with planting trees in Eretz Yisrael. You understand that. I wish it was like that. I wish, like, if there was enough kavanas, with Kabbalistic kavanas, that we had by planting trees and all this different stuff we spoke about, farmers and agriculture, that would be enough in order to completely dismantle and remove terrorism from the world. Alavai. But it's not like that. There is an inyan. The Torah is not stam. He has psukim about speaking about uprooting evil and uprooting ra. In order to mamash lechasel et ha-teror, to completely wipe out terrorism. Omnam, lifnei chen, but beforehand, yesh tzorech lehadgish ta-yachas ha-nachon bein ha-chesed la-gvura. What's the right relationship between chesed and gvura? Al pi ha-kabbalah, החסד מקביל ליד ימין של הגוף. When we say right, well, Kabbalistically speaking, we're referring to chesed, to love. ואילו הגבורה, and gvura emanates from the left side. Now, there's a lot of Torahs on this. We just have to know that that's the premise that we're working upon. ימין ושמאל, okay? ימין, chesed, אהבה, שמאל is gvura. He'll explain this in the context of this year, a certain way, there's a lot more to say about that, but not for now. בדברי חזל, ובכמה מקומות בהלכה הפסוקה, חבר'ה, is the air on it? Is the air on it?
Yeah? Yeah? I turned it off, maybe
you started. Okay, so leave it. No, I want it on. You didn't turn it off, right?
No, it's on.
Okay. In the words of חזל, ובכמה מקומות בהלכה הפסוקה, next page, מופיעה ההנחיה להקדים ולהגביר ימין על שמאל. So we have an halacha, we have different places, that right should come before left. What's a classic one?
Shoes.
בדיוק. The way we start in our day in the morning, right away we start the day like this. But it's interesting because you start with shoes, but you don't really finish it fully right and left. You understand? You put the first foot, it's supposed to be like this. You're supposed to put your first right shoe, then left shoe, but then you tie left and then you tie right. It's a hashlama. But starting, generally we speak about right, which would mean that what has to come first? Chesed, like in our approach to fixing things, right, the chesed has to come first. Ha'o v'hatov shel ha'chesed chayavim lehakdim ulakif et ha'choshech ha'yachasi v'et ha'dinim ha'kashim shel ha'gvura. In order for me to really enable gvura to play a role in my life, what do I need to surround myself with first? Love, with chesed. This is very important. In order for the yira of God to actually play a role in my life, I can't first start with yira and say to myself, love will eventually come and then I'll feel it. The way that Rav Ginsburg is mapping this out for us is that I first have to connect to mitzvahs and to my relationship with Hashem with an immense amount of ahava, of love, yamin. V'achareze, just like the halachas are, then I'll go to small. I think most of us could lehizdahot, how do you say that? Identify with that notion, no? I mean, I would say if you're in this shul and in this shir, you could probably identify with.
Not the way we were taught when we were kids. That's what we were laughing
most
about.
Of us, it's not the way we're taught. But our children, I think and I hope, have it much better than us, you know? Listen, we go into Ganim today and you see, not that a kid can read in Gan, but you walk into a Gan and so many of the Gans, they have Reb Shlomo's quote there. Kol ma sheyeled zakuk ba'olam hazeh ze ben adam echad le'amin bo. That's what they're getting now at such a young age. Like all that a child needs is one person to believe in them. That was not in my Gan. You know, that was not in my Was that in your Gan? No. These things are... So there is a shift. But he's saying like this. Kedei latzliach mechach, third line, tzarich ha'smol liot kalul kulo betoch ha'yamin. Left has to be fully included within the right. Gvura haba mitoch hekshel shel chesed. I have gvura in my life, but the context of the gvura is a love context, not gvura l'shem gvura. Elamai, gvura that's emanating out of chesed. Does that make sense?
It's a little bit the debate we were having on the Shira Tavid Chaverim last night.
Yes, yes.
That's the essence of, I think, the...
Yes, that's good. Nachon. What was the votes? I didn't see.
9-1.
Yeah.
That we should celebrate their downfall.
Right. Nachon. Nachon. I mean, there's a lot more chevra on that list. People are still scared to be politically incorrect, even on like an internal WhatsApp group. What is he going to think about me? Like,
well, Bruria said, who said they need to die? They should, the elimination from this world, by the way, I was not the one. But the elimination of a sinner from the world doesn't mean that they have to die. They could mean that they should repent. So Rabbi Meir Davin for them to repent, and they repented.
Now, this thing of Gevura that's emanating from Chesed, we've seen this in our life, and I think that for those of us that are still very much involved with parenting our children, we know that it's a must. Like, if we don't have Gevura in the house and it's just Chesed, in the name of, I love my children, I don't want them to happen to them, what happened to me, Hatzlacha. I mean, you may not be making the same mistakes that were made to you, but you're making a world of new mistakes that is going on to them. Our children without Gevura have no chance of learning any type of boundaries. But the thing is, the Gevura must always be rooted in a place of Chesed. The thing is that it's very hard to always remember that when we're in the moment of Gevura Dekachinuch. Because when we're in the moment of Gevura Dekachinuch, we sound different, we act different, and it triggers a lot of different components of Gevura that may not be connected to what we really want. He's going to give an example here, a different type of example, of where we've seen Gevura Shebegevura. You know, I had someone called me yesterday, and she wanted to organize a mass tefillah on Kever Shimshon right now. like right before Rosh Hashanah, she said to me that the Yanuka, you know the Yanuka? The Yanuka did this recently on Kever Shimshon, right here, and a big gathering, and she felt very strongly that we should dafka go to the Kever of Shimshon, the Gibor, right, the Gvura. Although today, can you imagine if Shimshon would emerge on the scene? You are an emergence of Shimshon every single day. To a certain extent, besides the women's stuff, like this. Yeah. What's that?
If not, it gives him
Shimshon.
Right. Nachon. So, she. I think it's a very beautiful thing. I just told her the only problem for me is that I'm a Kohen. I can't do it there, but there's other spots up there. Mamash here. Ben Tzorah v'Eshtal. Sorry, it's like Chevra here. I had one of the most boring dates in my life, not with my wife, on Kever, in that area. So I need a tikkun there, and I have to make it exciting. It was bichlal, not it. Who goes to?
There's good offering trail, right?
Huh?
We could take you offering.
A trail, yeah. Okay, tofa'a zo shel gvura, second paragraph. This phenomenon of gvura that emerges from a place of chesed, mitgalet b'me'ora le'umi yesodi, kriyas yamsuf. It becomes revealed in the most national, fundamental happening that happened to us in Am Yisrael, which is the crossing of the Red Sea. Chazal omrim, shelifnei kriyat yamsuf, kasher yivchinu bnei Yisrael b'mitzrim, harotfim acharim, vehevinu shem lichudim ben rotfeim leben hayam, achaz otam pachad gadol. We know the end of the story. We know that the sea split, and then we go entire Sinai, and then we eventually make it to Eretz Yisrael. But if you paused for a second, pay Dalit. If you paused for a second and you said, and you interviewed someone in the beginning of Parshas Beshalach, and you asked them before the miracles started happening, tell me, what are you experiencing right now? They'd say, we're freaked out of our mind. We're freaking out. Everyone's closing in. The Gemara explains this very visually. Animals, wild beasts coming from one side, the Mitzrim from another side, was one more thing, I forget what it was, from another side, because you have three sides basically, then the water, and then the water right in front of you, and that's it. There's nothing, there's no even shred of a hope or something. There was nothing going on. There was a pachad. There was a real pachad. That really happened. And a Yid saw that Am Yisrael is in such pachad, and at that moment, instead of fleeing from that pachad, he looked deep into his heart, and we know the rest of the story. Arba kvutzot hayu az ba'am. There were four groups in the Am at that moment that everyone was freaking out. Harishona kara leichana v'lachzor l'mitzrayim. There was a voice that says, pick up the white flag, let's go back to Egypt. Hashniya kara leisher l'ilachem. Another group said, let's stay here and fight. Hashlishit kara lanus l'midbar. A third group said, let's run away to the desert. Then another group said, let's continue straight into the water. Just want to see the footnote that he says here for this. It'll take me too long. I'll find it later. Huh? On Daf Kuf Einchet? Yeah, I have it. Pirka de Rabbeinu HaKadosh, the Rebbe has a whole sicha on this. We should learn this sicha this year. The Rebbe has a whole sicha, I see here in the Kutei Sichas. Okay. Thank you, Dov. L'chlal achra'a yigyu, but how did they come to a hachra'a, which is a word you're probably hearing a lot if you're following any Israeli media today. What's hachra'a? How do you say hachra'a in English? Does anyone know? Ani rotze le'achri'a oto. I want to have a decisive end result, huh?
Overcome.
To overcome, achra'a.
What's the
show? No, well, literally kara, which means to bow down, but achra'a, the context of it means like anachnu rotzim achra'a belevanon. We want a final resolution. Kien, keilu. So,
the, huh? Finish it.
like the old video games, finish him.
So the chlala achra'a, to end up, to the way you get to like this end, higiu, how did they know what to do? They only reached when Nachshon ben Aminadav, Nasi Shevet Yehuda, the Nasi of the tribe of Yehuda, umanigak vutzah revi'it, he was the leader of the fourth group, kafatz el hayam, he jumped into the water. Then all the indecisiveness came to an end, because one guy jumped in. But what drove him to jump into the water? Very simple. Moshe amar la'am, shematrat ha'yitziyah memitzrayim hi lekabel et ha'Torah mipi ha'gvura al har Sinai. Moshe told the people, the reason I'm schlepping you out of here in the first place is in order to receive the Torah from Hashem on har Sinai. Har Sinai nimtza harei me'ever layam. Where is Har Sinai? The other side of the ocean. V'im kach, barur sheyesh la'avor et hayam kedei le'agi alav, v'kach gam yiyeh. Nachshon said, well, that's it. Like, meaning, Moshe told us, the reason he's even bothering us with schlepping us out of here is because Hashem is going to give us the Torah on Har Sinai. Where is the Torah on Har Sinai? Where, baruch haba, ach shelanu yakar. Where is Har Sinai in this context? It's the other side, after the other side of the water. Nachshon ben Aminadav in his mind says, well, if Moshe Rabbeinu said that's why we're leaving Mitzrayim, then that's going to happen. That's going to happen. What would it mean? This may completely take us out of context. Let's try to stay clear. What would it mean today to be Nachshon today? What would it mean in our situation today, based on the logic that he just brought, that the Rav just brought down over here? So right in his mind, he has a munas tzaddikim that what? The reason why Moshe took us out is because we have to go and get the Torah. And if that's the case, the sea is going to split. Why? Because the Torah is there. Har Sinai is over there. So I believe so much in the words of the tzaddikim that I'm going to jump in because that's the way to get the Torah. And that's the purpose of us even leaving Yitzrayim, Bichlal. What would be the equivalent today? What does it mean to be Nachshon Ben Aminadav today?
Removal of all of our enemies, Harchavat HaGvulot, and Beit HaMikdash.
Okay, that's the Am. I'm talking about an individual. What would the individual look like today? What would he do? Yeah.
I mean, this is something I learned from Ari.
Yeah.
It just means to be unreasonable. Meaning each person in their own Nisayon in life, it just means like that's the right thing to do. That's what you think Hashem wants from you in your life. Be unreasonable. Just do what's right because it's right. And don't have to always do the cheshbonot of what is. It just means to be good and do what's right even if it's unreasonable.
Give me an example.
Making Aliyah. It's unreasonable. But just jump in. Don't do cheshbonot. Just do what you need to do. There's Levi. Made Aliyah. That's like unreasonable. He didn't know what he's going to do. He just came here. And now he's here. So it's just like doing what's right. You know, like, I'm right against my wife. Okay, well, just be unreasonable. Just say you're sorry and be good. Meaning, like, just do what you need to do to have shalom bayit. You know what I mean?
But you wouldn't possibly. Being unreasonable.
No, I'm reasonably good.
We're hearing about his morning.
Yeah.
You have no idea how boring it's been without you next to him.
Usually his shalom separates us.
I've separated you guys many times before. Yeah.
Where was Moshe?
Huh?
Where was Moshe?
He was, where was Moshe in the time of Pinchas too? It's a very good question what you're asking. Chazal asked that also. Where was Moshe here? Where was Moshe there? Moshe Rabbeinu, the greatest teacher, the manhig, really knew that he had to bring out the nekudos of different shvatim that could only come out if they starred. So Moshe Rabbeinu Dafka was saying this inyan of going of such mysterious nefesh. This is the tribe of Yehuda. I'm from Levi. This is the tribe of Yehuda. So he kept it there.
I mean, he
did, but Rav Ginsburg is going to explain to us how he came to that conclusion as well.
Do you have an insight into what a modern day Nachshon would do?
Is there a universal answer, or does it really have? Is it an individual?
You know what? I feel that everyone's right. So, Matt, I feel like Jeremy's right. What he just said, but Matt, I do. That that today we're sitting at a table here with a bunch of Nachshons. Everyone here is a Nachshon, certainly to a certain extent. But I also feel that we're still stuck in the bigger picture of Am Yisrael in Eretz Yisrael, and it may be weighing on the actions of one person. I don't know what that action. I don't have no idea what that is, but it seems to me like this Nachshon figure is like still waiting to emerge from within
was
the
Am. The Nasi of Shevet Yehuda. He was the Nasi.
Yeah.
Yosef Aaron gets up and does something. Yeshuga has something to do with
it. I'm not saying who it is. I'm not saying who it is, but a Dmut. There could be a Rav Rishi. I don't know. It could be the Prime Minister to act like Nachshon. I don't know. Learn that. I don't know. Okay, so let's see how he explains to us, though, how you get to Nachshon. This is very important, because we need this. Mefurash ki mekor nechishuto shel Nachshon. I love when he does this, because Rav Ginsburg always does this. He's like, you got to just look at names. So he's going to tell us two names. It says it's clear that the makor of the nechishut, nechishut means determined. His determinants of Nachshon, the same letters, is hinted in the name of his father. What's his father's name? Aminadav. Aminadav. What does that mean, Aminadav? Anin mitnadev leman ha'am. Like, I am having this serious nefesh for my am. That's how Nachshon becomes Nachush, through Ben Aminadav. He's the son of Aminadav. Mashmaut Hashem Aminadav, he lehitnadev avur amin. That's what it means. That's the word Aminadav. Is to, what's the right word for lenadev? To volunteer for my people. Emunato umesirut nafsho shel Nachshon navu me'ahavato umesiruto le'am Yisrael. His emuna. And his mesirus nefesh. He was able to jump into that water because he had one thing. What? He loved Yidden. He loved Yidden. He loved Am Yisrael. Habitui hagadol biyoter shel ahava hu lesayeh lanefesh ha'ahuva lehagi aliyada. And the greatest expression of love is to help a loved soul reach its destiny, its destination. Bemikre shel, like when you really love someone, how do you know you love them or not? If the role you play in their life helps them get to where they're destined to get to, like a real Rebbe, is someone whose kesher to his chassidim is so much love that they know that all he ever says to them is only to help them get to where they're destined to be. And that's it. And that's why they can mekabel. They can have bittul. They can mekabel anything from him. Now, במקרה של נחשון, התבטא הדבר בהבאת עם ישראל להר סיני על מנת להיפגש עם השם יתברך ושם לקבל את התורה. נחשון's case, it was expressed through bringing Am Yisrael to Har Sinai in order to meet God and to receive the Torah. Me'ein shushvinut yesh kan. You know what a shushvinin is? Hey, how do you say that in English? They say that in modern English, but really it's the one that brings the chasen to the kala. I guess like the quintessential shadchan, I guess. Mevi'im kala el chatana. You bring the kala to her chatan. Al menat lehachnisa lechupa vekidushin bekabalat haTorah. K'ma'amaram zah, b'yom chatunato zeh matan Torah. So the gvurato shel Nachshon imken nava me'ahavato le'am Yisrael. So Am Yisrael, so Nachshon, we don't know a lot about him, but what we do know is that he was in love with Am Yisrael, based on what he's saying over here, because that's the only way you can have real, sane Mesirus Nefesh. Insane Mesirus Nefesh is not something that may be rooted in love. It may be just meshuga and not directed and not right and not healthy. But like healthy Mesirus Nefesh can only come because you really are in love with the Am. Now Rav Ginsburg has another hint here. In Nun Zayin, in the footnotes, he says, Va'avat Yisrael shelo nav'a yeshirut mitoch ha'avat Hashem shelo. He says this in the Hayom Yom of Chav Chet Nisan, which is a very, very important date in Chabad calendar. Nachshon ole ve'ahavta es Hashem Elokecha. So the gematria of the word Nachshon is the same gematria as the word ve'ahavta. That's beautiful. What does it come out to? 414. 414. Yeah. All of the Be'ahavtas. ניתן לומר שבגבורתו הייתה דווקא ביטוי רב עוצמה של מידת החסד שלו. So you could see that his gvura was actually a tremendous expression of his chesed. I'm going to repeat it again. His gvura, doing what he did, was actually a huge expression of his chesed, of his love. I just can't help but mention Rav Kahana right now. It's just... I just can't help him, but not. His words were, over and over and over again, I don't hate Arabs, I just love Jews. And his pirut in this world, the way that it came out by him, was emanating from his chesed, seeing, you know, foreseeing everything that would happen to us, and loving Yidden, and being, yes, furiated and very, very bothered by different voices in the Am that didn't see it like that, but he loved Yidden, and he had Mesiras Nefesh. He was killed al Kiddush Hashem. Boy, we should live al Kiddush Hashem, Be'ezer Hashem. So again, Nitan Lomar shegvurato hayta dafka bitui rav otzma shel midat hachesed shelo. בקבלה מכונה התופעה הזו בשם התגברות החסד. So that's an interesting thing in Kabbalah. This concept is called התגברות החסד. What does that mean? Like, what does התגברות usually mean? להתגבר. Overcoming, right? התגברות means the acceleration of חסד. הוא מגביר. תגביר את when you want to turn something on, תגביר. Turn it up, right? תגביר. So here he's saying, התגברות of chesed. It's like you're turning up the volume of chesed through what? Gvura. Yeah.
It's like the Dalai always says, killing them with kindness.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but everyone's so focused on kindness, there's also the meaning of killing them.
Either way, you're killing them.
I hope, Bezrat Hashem, yeah. Yeah.
Could it be linked to this, like, sharing with the levels, with the different levels, and he surpassed the level of chesed to the next level of above it? Like, is the different levels in this, like, sharing?
Yeah. It's a different, it wouldn't add up perfectly, but I'm sure it's connected because the midot there are different. The levels there are a little bit different the way it works here, but I'm sure it's linked together. Bevadai, it has to be. So now let's end over here. The next paragraph, Gam Anu, next page, on Pehe, Gam Anu, by Ksher Shelanu, in our context, Medabrim al Hava'at Ahuv Liyado. In our context of fixing this Medina, what are we? In what context are we talking about? Bringing a loved one to their destiny. Just like Nachshon's whole thing was, well, I got to do this because my life is about love. And if I really love someone, I'm going to do what I'm going to do in order to bring them to their destiny, which would mean bringing Yidden to Har Sinai. So if we really love Am Yisrael, we have two things over here. One is that we have to get all the Yidden home, because we're destined to be here and nowhere else. But on the other hand, we have to make sure that home is Nazi-free, out of love. It's twofold. Meaning the gvura that I shared this last night, and you, I saw that you saw this. You guys know Rabbi Seth Farber from Ranana? He had such a, you know what I'm talking about? He had such an amazing post yesterday. He said his feed was filled with the most beautiful emotional comments of people that went to Rebo in Madison Square Garden. You want to say it? You remember it better than me? Because he said it. He said something so spitz, like so important. Yeah, gvura dik. It was gvura, but it's a great example of itgabrut hachesed.
He said it was so holy and it was so elevated and it was so transcendent. But I think his tefillah and his bracha was that they should actually harness that instead of to random, arbitrary, like, inspiration to Hashem and to Eretz Yisrael and to come home.
Yeah.
I don't think the essence of what he said.
Meaning we would love for that to just be like, wow, look at what a Kiddush Hashem happened in Madison Square Garden. And it was. It was the greatest Kiddush Hashem that ever happened in Madison Square Garden. But the point is not to just stay with did you see what happened in Madison Square Garden? The thing is, like, taking that and saying, listen to his lyrics, Lashuva Baita, Seder Avoda. His lyrics are all about what you're supposed to experience when you're coming home. Now, he'd be the first to say that if there was no microphone. You know, he'd be the first to say that. That's what we're talking about Hidgabrut HaChesed. But if you're going to go with the Aliyah pitch that's not rooted for real in Chesed first, by putting on your right shoe first, please don't represent the Jewish people. Please don't speak in the name of the Jewish people. Please don't. It's really like that about anything. But specifically right now about the, you know, bringing a Yid to his destiny, to his destination of Eretz Yisrael, do not speak b'shem ha'am. Don't speak in the name of the Am. Anu mevakshim la'vi et Am Yisrael le'artzo. We want to bring Am Yisrael to its land. Why? For what reason? Because we're like the Shushvinin. We want to bring the Chassan to the Kala to the Chassan. Al menat liyached lezaveg et ha'am. Ve'aretz b'kdusha u'b'tahara. Because this land that God designated for us is waiting for a zivug. It's waiting for a yichud. And the way that there's a yichud here is not by making sure that policies like status quo continue to remain the places in God's bedroom, Harabait, even though it's getting much better. It's still nothing close to what needs to be, obviously. We have to bring the chassan to the kala to the chassan, if we really love Am Yisrael. Now, in order to do this, l'shem kach, anu nidrashim li gvura rabba. The gvura place in us needs a lot of work, because it's not about starting to dance in the streets after seeing footage of what happened in Lebanon yesterday. But I'm sure there was a part of each of you that when you saw some of the gory footage of these terrorists that got blown up, it wasn't like them that they have this inner simcha inside of them, because that is like the Pere Adam that finally comes to life. I'm sure even in us there was this inyan of like, ouch, like, oh, like, but the gvura has to be like, Shem Reshaim Yerkav, Hashem runs the world, and there needs to be an elimination of all of these, all this evil in the world, in order to do what we're supposed to do here in this world. Like, it won't happen, it can't happen if they still exist. So we need a lot of gvura, but the gvura again has to have come from love. V'zot tzricha lavot dafka mitoch hitgabrut ha-chesed ve'ahava el amenu ve'el artzeinu. How do I know if my love is in the right place? Not if I'm so happy when I see only when bad things happen to my enemies, but more so when good things happen to my people. That's how I know that the ahava is in the right place. Meaning, if I'm just so in love with God and with this thing called Eretz Yisrael, when terrorists blow up, but I'm not sincerely happy in my heart, even infinitely more by going and greeting a plane of nefesh benefesh, like, because that, then it's off. Then the ahava and the gvura are not really there. The ahava must be rooted in the simcha I have for another Jew's happiness of anything in life, specifically of coming home. Like real rooted, mamash, deep, deep happiness. That's putting on the right shoe first. Only then, if I want to do things proper, then I can go to the left foot. And we need to do the gvura, but the gvura can only come in a healthy way when I really, really love. Listen, Reb Shlomo loved Yidden. He actually loved. It's crazy. He really, really loved Yidden. We have examples of people that loved Yidden. We live in the same century as the Rebbe. It's crazy to think so. But a human being like Lubavitcher Rebbe existed, meaning that we know it could be. It's possible to love. Ad bli dai. And then from there go and tune into the Gevura. Yad smol hi yad kasha. Left, it's hard. We need it. Chazaka v'takifa. Takif means, what's that?
Attack.
Like, it's connected to the word litkof, but takif means like conviction. Takif, it's a word in Ishbitz that comes up all the time. Takifus, a person has to have takifus, like, that I know I have to do this, even if it's hard. Ach, to go back to Rebo. Tocha, natsuf, ahava, but inside, the toch, the inside of the left of the of this is Ratzuf Ahava. It's only love. Sheota hi ba leakshim. It's only coming to manifest the love. That's really what it is. And I think that our greatest example today are our Chayalim HaKadoshim that are living like this all day long, every single day. They're willing to be killed because they love you and I. They do. Whether they realize it enough. They are. Their takifut, their gvura is coming from Ahava. So on whatever level we have to implement this, Hashem should give us the ometz halev, the courageousness of the heart to love people much more, to love Yidden much more, to stay away. I'm telling you, everyone that reads anything is so nervous because they feel like the Am has never been more mefulag. I call that out as the greatest fake news that ever was. It's not true. It's not true. The Am loves each other much more. You do have some loud people that are pashut me'od, confused, and they're loud, and they make kotarot. But the Am does love each other. I believe it. I'm not being naive. Yeah. I really don't think I'm being naive. The Am itself, the people, I see them when I go to sometimes big events and stuff. The people love each other. And we just have to lead the Gaber. We have to make sure that the world hears from real Mesirus Nefesh Dika, people like Bob's whole thing of wanting to get the voice of the Chayalim out there into the world. We need those voices of real Emes Dika, His Gabrus, Chesed. And it should be in our times that we finally get it right. Yaminu Smo, we finally get it right. Okay, Shkoach everybody.